take this. Who go first? This could be painful. We're playing amulet. He's not playing up. He's playing some. He's playing some two drops, but not a whole lot. So probably the Dryad. It's really bad. But him having this sucks too. Yeah, we'll take the Dryad, I guess. So I think Snare's come out. To draw a card. Play that. The Dryad is more the fact that it turns all their lands into all basic land types is. We've pretty much lost this game. So he has two amulets and a titan. So down curve. He'll give up the grazer for sure. I can Thoughtseize. Probably Thoughtseize is best. So we'll fetch up a island. We'll take out the Primeval Titan. And then we have the subtlety pitching spell snare. Or even the could pitch the sprite too. So we're screwed either way, pretty much. take the Titan. Well, we do that so we can deal with it. So he has to use that to go grab it. So it's Summoner's Pact, so. And then he went ahead and. So he's intending to play a Titan, which is okay. So we're gonna have to subtly Spell Snare here. And we'll definitely trade the snap for this Azusa. Well, we got through the wave. Get it the rest of the way. He has to pay this. This Warlike Cryptic Command is wonderful because into his turn you can bounce one of these lands and he just loses the game. So. Alright, well, we got some protection. So. Okay. We'll definitely have to. We're gonna have to bounce one. I also could bounce my Snapcaster to my hand and then make him sacrifice this. But this isn't really doing anything anymore. Yeah, let's just go ahead and draw. Okay. Yeah, I'm not worried about the Azusa. So he'll make a dude, we kill the dude. It'll be a 33. This is actually better. Yeah, we can do this. We'll bait. See, it's five cards, so I can't drown a Titan. So it's better just to kill this token as he tries to block here. And then on his draw we'll V-click in. Okay. So he's choosing not to block with the token, which is okay for us too. Yeah, we'll let this thing sit there. So one thing about his deck is they're mostly sorcery speed stuff. Bye. That's why we do it. Wait, how? Oh, okay. E-map. Hey, we can still kill this. And we hold this to block now. A two. Ridiculous. The problem is with these cards is one of them's not a problem. It's when they back to back them. That's the issue. could block. Yeah, well, grab a swamp. So the spell sort of sprite may have should have. Been played earlier. I mean, it would have been free damage, but I didn't know that at the time. I don't understand why. The rest of the turn. I might just, well, if I stand still, he's gonna have an army. That's the problem, is this thing, they do nothing. They have an established board, do nothing and get this. Like, it's quite annoying. So I can't bounce this if I want, but we'll just hit for three in the air, hold this back. We probably won't end up blocking with this. We might block the Azusa just to trade. Goes the nine. So I have blockers, so can I hold off for a couple turns? I think trading for the Azusa here is worth it. He might not attack at all. Okay, he did. So I'm going to be able to get but he just makes another one and they attack with two next turn. But I can also bounce this. He'll have the same scenario. Yeah, I should probably take this turn. Take here. We bounce end of turn. What? Oh, I have an instant. Oh, that's nice. So this costs less because I have a legendary creature. Oh, that's nice. Well, if I would have known that, I would have not taken 3 damage. I forgot. Oh well. So if we lose by... If we lose, that's why. Go, that's a great draw. Here. Wow. Well, we just kill it immediately, so. Yep. So we can stop Stony Pact. So I should be at 6 life. So been holding this spell surge right the entire game. So I can't counter a primeval type. So I need to keep that in mind. Nice. So we just block with the Snapcaster here. And we hold everything up. Worst case scenario, we bounce the token. Glad we got there. Force negate it. So E's come in. Push probably comes out. They're hard to activate. And we got Edict instead. Aether Grass is fine. Run to Vortex is fine. Thrustdowns, eh. They don't really use their graveyard much. And Mordigo can come in. Spell Snare's out. It doesn't do enough. It can. It can do a lot. It really can. It just... I don't think we're there yet. So, and then... We don't want a Sprite early. So, I think we take out a Sprite. Sprite late's fine. Sprite early bad. And you don't want to take them all out because they deal with the summoner's packs. But drowns also do the summoner's packs too. Okay. Force negation is like one of those things that's like, eh, it's so situational. Okay, we mulligan the sand. It's kind of a hard. Because one's reactive, but I can't activate it unless I have the other blue card. I'm definitely not getting rid of Thoughtseize, not in this matchup. So we're going to play the EE on 0. I could play the EE on 1 as well. Go ahead and play land, EE on 0. Just to get it out there. I don't want him to have, like, Force of Vigor and, blow me up. Let's see what we're working with here. Prime time and a bunch of land. Okay, he kept... It's not a bad hand for him in a lot of ways. It probably is bad. Did he mulligan? He mulliganed to 6 cards off that, so the way he's gonna get the way he's going to get back in this game is with Urza's Saga. So we have to kind of respect that a little bit. I kind of wish it would have kept subtlety. But the V-click is nice, or will be nice. I'm going to keep the Engineered Explosives in my hand. I'm going to threaten Counterspell here. Not that it matters too much, but... And then on his next draw, we're going to V-click. Okay. Do I need double black? Yeah, I'll just get an island. Summoner's Pact. Yeah, we can't let him start going off. So we'll take it away. Give him something else. So he drew into a dismember. We're going to do, we're going to V-click again on his draw. We're down on time as well. Bye-bye. We're actually getting some really good draws here. Man, my... So, we're going to try to end this game pretty quickly if we can. Need another card in his graveyard, but we only have two cards. We'll attack, go to 13, and then we'll play Blossom. I could also play the mana efficient thing and put E on one, but I want to keep the other E in my hand. Probably gonna do six here. Unless I get like a counterspell in my hand. That changes pretty much everything. And that's not the kind of counterspell I wanted. I mean, I could stop. Alright, we'll, hey, we're gonna hold it up in case he has Summoner's Pact. It does wreck us. But doing... Sucks. Man, why can't he have one more card? That's not fun. That really sucks. just need cars in their graveyard. I'm gonna block at the end of turn endurance. So there's a lot of reasons to do that. Getting that card in his graveyard is like huge though. All right, so jeez. All right. We got a couple scenarios here. All right, he stacked these wrong because now if he was playing Pithy Needle, he can't do this anymore. So he's going to get an amulet. We know that already. Now if he goes to get Pithy Needle, it's kind of worthless. Fails to find. Transmute Telluria West. I'm sure for a summoning pact. Yep. Then we obviously just counter that. We do everything in our power to counter that. Okay. So we just pass turn. It really sucks to start our fairy count over again, but yeah. So he's gonna. That sucks. But we'll just edict it away. So we can still win here. So we definitely can. But it's going to take some time and I'll probably lose the clock actually. But I think we're in a winning position. That's a good draw. And then to finish him off, we can tar pit at like the very very end. We're just not tar pitting because we know he has Summers back in hand from that transmute. It's bad. Okay. It's just so slow. Now, this is something we can't deal with. We'll have to deal with it the old-fashioned way. So he's going to play the Titan. We kill the Titan. We make him put all the junk into it, give it haste, and right before that, then we make him sack it. Uh-huh. We make him. He's playing more of a normal. Yeah. I wonder if he's playing Valkyts. So, and this is where we. This really screws him up now. Because he's down to 3 mana. He can play something else. He has land drops. So, I think we're in a good position to win the game here. The only bad thing is he does have 6 cards in hand. But if he has no threat, we can start beating here. And then have Edict up. Okay, so we'll see. where this goes. We're not worried about this at all. If he gets an amulet out, yeah, sure. And we've held this explosive in our hand just because we don't know whether to put it on one or zero. So. But he goes to 14, and then if he has to have something going on, and we have everything but a counter spell, but I can counter anything in his deck anyway because I've drowned. We're happy here. We're really happy here. We're going to win this game. So, and in real life, we would have the